Hello. This is a Pollux 7000. There's some special stuff going on. There's an interactive element on the key, and there is a master ring inside. How this works exactly is explained very well by the Lox Nest. I'll put a link to the video in the description. It was very helpful for me to find out how to get this lock. But now I'm just going to try to pick it first and gut it afterwards. As I said, there's a mastering in there, which means there are two shear lines. And to open the lock, you have to pick to one of those shear lines. On top of that, some of the pins are tapered, so you'll have to set them a couple of times. It's also pretty easy to overset something, so I'll probably have to play with tension a little bit to try to get things to drop back, but let's see how it goes. In the beginning, it's just pretty straightforward. Find a binding pin and set that and make sure it's loose. You don't want to be too enthusiastic, because then you'll definitely overset something. Getting some core movement. So there are probably things very close to being set. Sparrow slider pick for this one. Just like I used on the, what was it called, Fontaine? I think I overset something now. More than one thing, because I felt that going. So, and I think I lost a lot. So let's start over. Worry about, it just happens. Sometimes you make a mistake. If I were Bob Ross, I'd call it an happy accident, but I'm not, so. energy movements again. I think I'm getting close. I'm open. You can see it rotating. Don't want to rotate it too far because it'll look again. And I don't want to pick it 360. Not in the mood. Show you it can rotate freely. See that? And it's locked again. Okay, now the gutting. I had to prepare the lock. I had to remove these four pins. They're on the tray over there. I had to remove four pins like these to be able to remove this bar, but it's very snug, so I had to use some force. Yeah, let's start with that. Let's get this part off. If that still works. There we go. This one first. With the cam. There we go. Very solid bar. Okay, and now there's a pin in the bottom. And to remove that, I have to push a little bit on the again. Yep, it's coming. Oh, let's remove this bar first. This is a very important part because without this, the interactive part of the key wouldn't work, and the key wouldn't work. But again, that's explained very well in the video by the Lock's Nest. Okay, I think I need to be a little more violent. Let's get something. Yet. It's something. I need something to put. Where's my rubber mat? This side a little bit, and this over here. Where's my mat? I was prepared for a lot, but not this. What can I put underneath to protect my? Take this piece of leather. Okay. It's coming. Okay, apparently the pin came out. Because the back also came out. Yep, there we go. So, Let's be careful. All right. So, this is the pin that came out. Let's put that over there. There's a spring. Let's put it back. So, this back piece was held in place by that pin that went in there. And there are seven springs, and there you can see seven pins. So let's get those out as well. How am I going to do that? I'm going to rearrange my. I'm going to put these pins over here. I didn't think this through. I'm going to put this over here. And get my tweezers. Our own tweezers. There we go. Okay. So, bear with me. I'm going to lower the camera a little bit. Let's start with the springs. Oops. And that's how you lose a spring. Always pay attention. To work clockwise, and the last one. There we go. Springs are all the same. Let's have a look at this. Nothing weird going on there, besides it just being a weird thing in itself. Think, what am I going to do? Maybe I can push it up with the key. Yeah. Do you see that? Ooh. Okay. Tweezers. I'm going to pick this. Take these out first. Okay. So this is the top. This goes to the side of the spring. You can see how tapered they are. Let's take out the first. I'm trying not to obstruct the view with my hand. I'll show you a close-up of the pins later. Doesn't want to go, so let's help it with the key. Ooh, that one came out. That's number six. They also have a serration, some of them. Not all of them, but some of them. Okay, when I push the key, I can see there's a... Oh, I can see this one is coming out already. That's 6 again. So I'm going to grab that one as well. Why am I missing one? Did I miss 6? Did I mess up already? I think I did. Oh boy, this is going to be fun. I rotated. What am I missing? I didn't get 7 yet, didn't I? I don't think so. Maybe I should have. Let's try that. I'm just experimenting now. Shouldn't, but hey, why not? Okay. So. I'm thinking out loud now. Let's do this. Is that a pin? That was a pin. Was that 7? I think that was 7. I didn't notice that. It was stuck in the middle because of all the grease. So. Back. I've already got 6, 7. I'm going to do 1, 2, 3. Ooh, that's a long one. 4 and 5. And finally, there's the key pins. I'll call them key pins. Let's help those with the key carefully. So 2. Or 6. Seven. Yeah, it doesn't go deeper. Three. Okay, there are 3 more left. You can see those are, well, this is at shear, but those are below shear, so this key doesn't work on the first shear line, it works on the second one. Dirty lock. That's number 3. And finally number 4. There we go. Might as well clean it up before I reassemble. Interesting. So, show the parts again, back piece, the middle, and the front part. So, there you can see the two shear lines. Very nice. I like it. Let's show some pins. So, I'm going to call them key pins. All the key pins look like this. So, very tapered at the end. And most of the, let's call them drivers, look like this with a serration. Oh, the middle, let's call these the middle drivers. They have a taper where they touch the key pin, they have a serration and a taper on the end where they touch the second driver. And the second drivers also have that taper, a serration, and on the end they're just flat. And there are also two, the smallest second drivers that don't have that serration. So, very cool lock. Let's show it again. Very nice. Hope you can see it well. This was a fun pick. A very messy gut, but I think I survived. And the lock survived. I didn't mess up too bad. If you're still here, thank you for watching and have a nice day.